No, shut up, shut up. I've just made, like, how big a dick have I just made of myself? In no, have I made this big a dick of myself, or have I made that big a dick of myself in HMV? I went in and I got a couple of mates of mine, they're a little bit studently, but they're all right. They told me about this brilliant rock and roll band, right? And all I remembered, it was a medical phrase, and they were really hip. So I've gone into HMV, hi, how you doing? Can we help? And they've gone like, Engelbert Humperdinck Records, right over there. I've gone, do what? I'm here to buy some new rock stuff. Got any placenta? Oh. Nightmare, absolute nightmare. You know my feelings, don't you, about personal hygiene. Always have a good shower and give yourself a nice spray before you go out. I bought this, someone actually bought it for me, the little one out of the Cranky's bought it me. He said, wear this, but every time I put it on, I'd walk into a bar, go up to girls and say, hey, how you doing, nice to meet you, and they'd go, leave it, not, just go. So I've stopped wearing it now, look, don't. You know, you're not even giving yourself, oh, bless her, she's so sweet, she's such a sweetheart, and I don't want to, it's kind of, shall I let her down gently? I'm going to have to give it right to her and say, dear Dame Thora, I feel the same way, but this can't possibly, look what she sent me, look, bless her, look. I love you because you are my friend. And it's, yes, but don't, I'm not your special friend. Do you know, it's never going to, oh, God, are they doing blind date? Well, you'll have to get someone will have to go, because Scylla was round here. So she was round here last night with our Bobby. She come, hello, our Robbie, I'm in our Bobby. Oh, all right, just a small one. All right, she's come. Well, next thing you know, it's 4 o'clock in the morning, and I've only just found that she's doing, look, she's left them behind, look, bless you. You know what I mean? How funny is that going to be tonight? And night number two, our lovely Debbie from Stockwell. It's not going to be the same. What have we got in the cupboard? Let's have a look what we've got in here. Oh, God, I can't even begin to tell you the trouble I've had here. Have a look at this, look. Here we are, look. Bamba Gascoigne come round my house, right, which is always a nuisance when he comes round, because I've always, hello, Bamba. Hi, Bob, you started for tent? No, just hello, Bamba. And I gave him some of this, right? Fingers, right? So he's eaten half of them, and Louise from Maternal came round, and I said, finish off these, right? Finish off these biscuits that Bamba Gascoigne had. She couldn't cope. She just, I can't, so I had to give her these. Incredibly thick chocolate. No, because she can manage that, bless her. You know what I mean? Well, all right, that's it. Now let's see what Mafanwy's got planned. Shall we have a look? I don't quite understand what we've... Well, we've got a bunch of flowers she's got in here. A nice bunch of flowers and... Excuse me, but I think that's a dirty book. Bunch of flowers and a pornographic magazine. Let's see. Oh, that's very funny, Mafanwy. Very funny Welsh joke. Self-raising flower. Don't encourage her, because she just goes back to the valleys. Oh, they think I'm right funny, like, you know. You're not funny, my friend, you're just dirty back. Now, as it happens, you're very lucky to find me, obviously, because normally this time of night I'd be out and about.
Well, do you remember where it was? Well, I'm in the road we was in last night. Well, I was just as drunk as you, so I'm just talking to Baby Spice. Yeah. Well, you shouldn't... Yeah, there's a gold coloured car. You took your shoes off in front of the car, and then you, I don't know. I've got them. I found them. It's all right. I found them. I'll bring them around your house. All right, Baby Spice. Speak to you later. Silly cow.
Took her shoes off. Just going drunk we were the other night. I'll take them around your house. Right now, as usual, I've got some. Actually, do you mind if I do something first? Don't. What I wanted to do, I wanted to entertain this night. I wanted to do a little bit of magic. And obviously, like any fine magician, top magician, I need some vibe. Could I have your hand, madam, just for a sec? There, I just want to get some vibrations. Can you feel the vibrations? Can you feel them, my love? Can you feel them? And can I have your hand, madam? Just, nice. Oh. Just getting the vibrations. That's all it is, my love. I'm just getting the vibrations, that all. Now, I do want to do, has anyone got a hanky? Have you got a hanky, so I can borrow? Oh, it was just placed on your lap. Haven't got another one, have you, sir? Slightly clean. No, this one's fine. Now, let's come back. Now, we don't usually do this kind of thing, ladies and gentlemen, but as you know, I am a member of the Magic Circle. Oh, I'm not supposed to tell you that. Oh, no, that's all right. It's the Masons, I can't tell. Oh, damn it! Right, I want to do a trick for you now, ladies and gentlemen, that I think will beguile and amaze you, right? What have we here? An empty glass, thank you. A perfectly empty glass. Now, I'm going to place that in there. I think I've got enough vibrations. And then I'm going to put that hanky over it there, ladies and gentlemen, like this. You get there? And then... Where's the handkerchief? It's gone, it's disappeared right now. Thank you very much. Thank you. Absolutely fantastic. Right. We're just going to do... I'll tell you what we'll do now. Yes, I'll tell you what we're doing now. Sorry. That's how you're supposed to start a TV programme, like that.
I'd just like to try and do a little magic, if I may. I'm going to ask you now, would you mind just sort of holding my hand for a moment, because I do need a little vibration for this. Now, I'm going to ask you to think of this word in a special way. I'm going to ask you to think of it, just hold my hand a little longer. Do you get a tingle? You don't? It's because I'm too old.
One of the most talented magicians, ladies and gentlemen, that you're ever going to see. And all he does there is getting a little bit of vibration, all right? And he only does that on that trick. It's not like every trick he does, he has to touch somebody, because that would just be stupid, wouldn't it?
You really should come and do this in a sort of close-up so you can actually see how marvellous I am at doing this, because this is a cigarette. Now, if you watch closely you'll see how it's...
No need for that, you see. That's not... No, you're not getting any vibrations there, are you? You see where the problem is.
It's only practice.
Now, what you're going to see now, ladies and gentlemen, is you've probably never seen this man before, because Paul Daniels came along and people like that and stole his thunder. But this, right, not him, but somebody else on this programme, is going to do a trick. Well, I've seen it 1,000 times and I think it's camera work. I can't believe that it isn't done with trick photography. It's absolutely stunning.
Well, these two experts here, I think, could show you a thing or two. James?
I hope so. Are you going to show me some magic? Come on, show me some magic. I think I'll come over this side, if I may.
Yes, I thought you might.
Over here, what? Can I help you at all?
Have you got a handkerchief?
It so happens. Funny you should ask. I do have a handkerchief. Is that all right?
Moment of drama.
Absolutely fair and above board so far.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. I don't believe it. I really
That's
don't believe
good.
It.
Well,
I think you're marvellous. Thank you. Where's the
handkerchief?
It has
the hanky's disappeared, ladies and gentlemen. Take that child out and burn her at the stake. She's a witch. Oh, I've gone all spooky down my back, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, well, a little bit more magic. Let's have Kavari. You'll remember Kavari. You remember Kavari. Funny bloke, big beard, no head. Oh, yeah.
Welcome.
Thank you,
everyone. What do you think of young Michael?
Very good. Very good. Indeed, yes, very good.
And who's this lovely lady? Michael Wells, suddenly get a little bit Peter Wingard, isn't he? And who's this? Must be your lovely wife, is it? Lovely to meet you, madam.
The lovely Susan.
Yes, Susan.
And Angela.
Angela, and I believe lovely. Susan's your lovely wife.
Yes. Lovely. Oh, being. I see. Hang on a minute.
Concern. You're going to do something, one of the tricks that we're going to see next Saturday, but you're going to show us now.
I'm going to sue Angela in two halves.
All right, this is Angela. This isn't Susan, your lovely wife, then. Where's Susan, your lovely wife?
In fact, to do this, we're going to need this sword.
I see. Susan is your lovely wife. Okay.
Angela, would you like to come over there, lift your hands up, turn around, please, because I wanted everyone to see that Angela is still...
15 years younger than my wife.
It's sensational. Nivea Soft. A new softness for my skin. Instantly. It's just amazing. So light and quickly absorbed. It's like gentle summer rain on my skin. sensational. New Nivea Soft. The soft sensation for beautiful skin.
New Magnum Ego. Crunchy almonds and amaretti, a river of fruits of the forest sorbet, and thick Magnum chocolate. Magnum Ego. Life is all about priorities.
You can reach me by railway. You can reach me by trailway. You can reach me with your mind. You can reach me by sailboat. Climb a tree and swing rope to rope. I don't care how you get here, just get here if you can.
Happy days. I'm just sitting here reminiscing about some of the times I've had in the recording studios. This is a friend of mine, Big Johnny. This is me and Big John. This is an album that we did together many, many years ago. I don't know if you... Me and John Lindemann, are you being served? And hey, I can tell you this, I was. Nah, it's a bit of showbiz gossip. Now, a more interesting book that I've written, though, right? A very, very strange thing happened to me on my travels in Africa. I was in Burkina Faso, Upper Volta, as it was, and I was driving through Burkina Faso, and I came to a customs post on the border crossing, and I went through it, and imagine my surprise when I found myself where? Zaire. I'd gone straight from Burkina Faso into Zaire, and I was so... I came home and I wrote a book just, you know, about it, basically. There is a... Whatever happened to Somalia? Just not there. It was. I was stunned. I was visibly moved. That's what happened to me. Right, I'll tell you what we've got here now. Oh, these are my favourites. Of all the programmes that I make, these are probably my favourites, right? These are the shows I make with the psychics, because, you know, I'm very much in touch with the spirit world. You're aware of that, aren't you? Oh, when Scylla and Bobby come round. And this is a little program that I've made, one of my favourite psychics, who's not just a psychic, but she's a proper doctor, all right? Because she knows all about proper medicine as well, right? There we go, let's have a look at her.
Now, Francesca, I know that you strongly believe in mental causes of disease. Do you want to tell me a little bit more about these?
Yes, certainly. It basically means that everything that's wrong in your body, every illness, every physical condition, has a mental cause. And that basically, if you review your life and your feelings and get rid of the mental blockages, you actually cure your physical body.
What kind of things are typical?
Everything from a pain in your little finger right through to cancer.
Everything from a pain in your little finger right through to cancer. It's caused not by medical conditions, but by mental conditions. You want to listen to what this woman says, so I'll tell you, mugs, I'm like, you will learn.
Because each part of your body represents particular thoughts, right. You see. The common things, I mean, sore throats is not speaking your mind. Right. The only per se people are a pain in the neck, or pain in other parts of the anatomy as well. You usually tend to get very tense around those areas.
Right, no, shut up. No, yeah, would you sit there, Royal College of Surgeons, giggling like fools? No. This woman, I happen to know. Right, what she's saying is absolutely, if you've got a pain in your neck, right, think about the person you're with, right? And you'll find that there's something wrong with your relationship. You'll find that it's actually a mental, if you've got a, say you've cut your finger, your finger's bleeding quite badly. Now think about it. Are you having problems at home in a relationship? It's all true. And I'll say one of the other things is we learn about this when we come into show business. If you're a complete charlatan, right, that gives you a very nasty cough. Anyway, shut up now and listen, because this is interesting.
excuse me.
Right, well, we'll come back to that in the second half.
Right,
you can go and recharge your psychic batteries in time for the calls.
Get rid of my calls.
Now, if you do have a health problem, Frank...
What have they told her in her earpiece? Woman's a nutter. Whatever you do, we don't want any legal actions. Just get us off the hook, okay?
Now, if you do have a health problem, Francesca can help, but you should also go and see a doctor.
It might help just to get a second opinion. Anyway, no, she's a psychic, and boy, whoa! If Dorothy Stokes was alive, she would be saying about, well, probably is already, about this woman. She is the queen of the psychics. Absolutely fantastic.
Hello, Maria.
Hello.
Hello there. So I'm laughing as you're asking about relationships.
Yeah.
It's not been the easiest part of your life, has it?
You sarky cow. You never even met the woman. You just took it up. This is, there's two things about her. A, she's absolutely the most sarkiest woman in the world. B, she's rubbish. And C, she's got a total mental fixation with building societies.
No, to say the least. You really wonder if it's worth it.
Yeah.
Yeah, in fact, if I was you, I'd be wondering if it's worth it. I know anyway, but... oh, you poor thing. Lots and lots of spirit help for you, I must say. You do seem to know quite a lot of people that have passed over, and I've got one lady, please, that's not family. She's actually friend, but I want to say a little older than you. Can you understand, please, a friend that's gone that's been a few years older than you? Quite elderly, someone that you would have... seen quite a bit towards.
Do you know any old people who have died? I'm widening for you, sweetie. Help me, lovey.
I feel could have helped out as well. Not so much with her illness, but just running errands for her, that type of thing. Do you have any links to Cheltenham and Gloucestershire?
What the hell's that got to do with anything?
No.
Relationship, please. Yeah, have you got two people around you?
Two people? No.
Yeah, two relationships. No.
God's sake. I'll tell you what's coming on now, Fitzroy. Fitzroy, he out-weirded her. Because Fitzroy phoned up from somewhere in the Midlands or somewhere, and all he wanted to know was, would it be possible, please, to get someone who died and gone to heaven, was sitting on a cloud, maybe just sitting there playing their harp with nothing better to do, could they come around and help him with his garden, please? A little bit of hedgerow cutting back, a little bit of pruning, a little bit of distaffing. Let's look.
And our next caller is Fitzroy from Nottingham. Hi, Fitzroy.
Hello.
How are you?
Fine, thank you.
What do you want to talk about specifically with Francesca today?
Say if I have a general reading, health, business, money, and say if I have a garden angel.
Gardening angel. Monty, you want Monty Don, lovey.
Tall order. General reading, business, health, money. Over to Francesca.
She'll help you out.
Hello there, Fitzroy.
Hello, Francesca.
Hello, we all have a guardian angel, by the way.
Ha ha.
Do you have any connections to London?
To London?
Hmm.
My dad. Family might live over there.
So I can't hear very well. Your dad's family, because I'm just seeing the stretch of the Thames here. It's a bit of north, a bit of south, so I don't know which side I'm on. There's quite an industrial area around the Thames. I don't know what that means, but it's certainly somewhere that you're going to be visiting in the future.
I'll tell you what it means, sweetheart. You've been watching EastEnders. That's what it is. That's what it's the little end titles, darling, from EastEnders. It's just the map. It doesn't mean he's got anyone living there, lovey. Come on. Right, she gets on a winner, okay? Suddenly she's on a winner, because she's hit onto careers, she's got into someone's vocation, and wow, she's cracking it. It now becomes spooky, 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 spooky rubbish.
Hi, Lorraine.
Hello.
Hello there. So, okay, I want to talk about career matters and work with you. Is that the sort of main thing at the moment?
No, not at the moment, no.
First thing I want to say is around
work. Sure it's not?
And going into some new work in the near future, but it's going back to something, so I don't know if you've given up something years ago.
Yes, I have.
Yes!
Years ago, yeah. That you'd like to get back into.
Yes.
It seems to be like a vocation that you would have really loved.
Yes.
All right.
Look at that big smile on a roll. Yes. Now I'm cooking. Now I am the baby psychic. Let's go.
Is this dealing with people quite a bit as well?
Yes, it will.
And young people?
Yes.
Or at least it will be next time?
Yeah.
All right. So I don't know if you're teaching or something like that, but it seems to be dealing with quite a lot of children, but they're older children as opposed to younger children. But it's not just the children, it's adults as well. going back to it, though.
Well, I haven't really thought about it at the moment.
Aha, you will now.
I haven't really thought about it at the moment.
Haven't you?
No.
Oh, well, you will, and quite often.
Because I'll send you a tape of this show. So she's on a roll. Come on, you're on a roll. Look, what easier thing could there to be, right? If somebody phones you up, a woman, you say, someone in the spirit world, is it your mum? All right, maybe their mum's not dead, 50-50 chance. No, but your grandmum, is it? Yeah, eventually, you're going to go back until you find someone who's died, right?
Is your mother in the spirit world?
No.
Is mother-in-law in the spirit world? I've got mum here.
No.
Is there anyone else you used to call mum? Or was known to the family as mum by? It's mum, and she won't give me any more information. She just keeps calling mum and giving me March birthday passing anniversary with her.
No.
No. There's never been anyone in my entire family called mum. Ha 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 ha. But the fantastic thing about this is that there's such an easy way out. It's absolutely lovely, look.
Someone who always wanted a son. So it's someone that didn't want a son. Or didn't have a son, sorry, but wanted one. So I'm being called to time.
I'm sorry, I've run out of time.
Okay, thank you.
Bye.
Thank you. I was just about to crack it, and unfortunately, I've run out of time. Oh dear. What a terrible shame. Just before we go, I just want to go back to the thing that she was saying. It does make a little bit of sense. I think we all agree that now, that any physical problems you have might have a base in a mental thing. I don't know if there's any of you ladies either at home or out there who maybe your legs put on a little bit of weight and you're getting the little dimples. You get in there. But of course, you know what that is. That's the trapped dreams. That's a dream that you've got that you can't fulfil. That's all that is. But, I mean, you all knew that anyway, obviously.
Now, Francesca, if you'd like to join me, before we were talking about the mental causes of disease.
That's right.
Going to ask you is, how can you cure these diseases psychically?
Well, it's not so much psychically, it's just really, it's like another theory I have. You know, women tend to get cellulite, men don't.
Yeah.
Because cellulite represents trapped dreams.
Women have more trapped dreams
than men, don't we? So basically, you fulfill your dreams. You do whatever it is necessary to actually get rid of it. As I say, if somebody is causing you a huge burden on your shoulders, walk away from the situation, if that's possible, or at least don't absorb it, don't let it get to you.
So
you
focus on the problem and
that's
then
right,
move on.
That's right, because some people do move away from things, but it's still affecting them, so you just can't let things affect you too badly.
As well as
it's working through psychologically, really.
There you go, absolutely perfect, and any problems that you've got, we'll deal with them here, all right? I presume they've finished now, you haven't got anything else to say of you ladies before we go?
But you should also, of course, go and see a doctor.
Yes, go see a doctor. Because you never know, he might have a handle on stuff as well, anyway. Anyway, I've got to go because I've got a terrible pain in my leg, and I think it's because I'm worried about paying my gas bill. I'll see you later. Ta-da. Oh. Seems to be the trouble here.
Can I ask you a little bit?
Finger. Is it a problem with your job? Are you worried about your job? Are you worried about your prospects? Do you feel like you want to change your job to go back to something that you used to do? Is it gardening? Are you worried about gardening? Because obviously this is something psychosomatic. Is there a? I'm seeing a pet. Oh. I'm hearing Timmy. Have you got a brother called Timmy? Is your father's name Timmy? Have you got an uncle Timmy? Is there anyone whose name might be something else but you refer to them as Timmy? I'm sorry, I've run out of time.